Hello, Scramble family. Today we're reading Pandamonia by Chris Owen and Chris Nixon. So you're here at the zoo on this glorious day. You're sure to have fun. It's a great place to play. Come in, look around, relax and explore. Inside you will find there are creatures galore. You'll have a magnificent time at the zoo. Just don't wake the panda, whatever you do. If you wake up the panda, he gets very grumpy, which hypes up the hippos and makes them all jumpy. When the hippos get jumpy, they usually hop, and once they begin, they're tricky to stop. Those hippos create such a hullabaloo, so don't wake the panda, whatever you do. When the hippos start hopping, the termites get tickly. They make the echidna incredibly prickly. For though, as you probably know, they are titchy, cantankerous termites are awfully itchy. They torment the toes of the elephants too, so don't wake the panda, whatever you do. The zebra, giraffe, and hyenas all laugh. The geckos and gibbons all giggle, which causes the emus to shimmy and sway, and the tapirs' bottoms to jiggle. The chimps chit-chatter, the ducks start quacking, the jabberoos jabber, and the yaks start yakking, so waking the panda might spark off a riot, and that's why we like to keep things nice and quiet. When the yaks start yakking, the frogs start humming, the bilbies bop, and the baboons start drumming. The air is filled with a deafening din, sending the wallabies into a spin. They bounce to the beat with the red kangaroo, so don't wake the panda, whatever you do. If the wallabies bounce, the bats start swinging, the scarlet macaws and the galahs start singing. Their swinging and singing sets off the raccoon, whose barking is usually way out of tune. That raucous raccoon makes a racket, it's true, so don't wake the panda, whatever you do. The snakes serenade as the peacocks parade and the devils start gnashing their jaws. And when the koala whips up more palaver, the penguins break into applause. The wombats wiggle, orangutans romp, lemurs leap, and the rhinos stomp. The ground vibrates and the treetops shake. Yes, waking the panda would be a mistake. When the treetops shake, the sloth starts to shuffle, which ends up creating a mighty kerfuffle. For though sloths are slow and appear rather lazy, if they're in the mood, they can really go crazy. The crocodile, too, starts snapping on cue. So don't wake the panda. Don't wake the panda. No, don't wake the panda, whatever you do. When the crocodile snaps, the lion will roar. The bison and buffalo bellow for more. A frenzy of animals flocks to the floor. And that's when you know there is trouble in store. The black cockatoos like to screech rock and roll. The toucans can can-can right out of control. The grizzly bears start to rumba as well. And even the tortoise comes out of her shell. Flamingos and dingoes all do the fandango. The chinchillas cha-cha, the tamarins tango. Yes, waking the panda would cause a stampede. And here at the zoo, that's the last thing we need. There's grunting and growling and prancing and prowling. Skipping and scowling and squealing and yowling, squeaking and squawking, gnarling and snorting, hysterical howling, chaotic cavorting. Then just when you think that the rhythm might slow, the beasts go wild and the louder they grow. Into the night the shenanigans flow as they dance in the light of the glowworm's glow, singing zoo-bop-a-loo-bop-a-wham-bam-boo. So don't wake the panda. Please don't wake the panda. No, don't wake the panda, whatever you do. Oops.
Thank you for joining us for Scramble Storytime and Crafts. We're here for you and your family during this unusual time, and we're proud to offer contactless curbside pickup. Just check out our online store at goscramble.com on the shop tab for a wide range of books for all ages.